our founding values, principles, and mission. Allow me now, comrades, to introduce the man who is none other than His Excellency, the President of Zambia and the President in waiting of the Republic of Zimbabwe. Comrades, Emmerson Damuzo Mnangagwa.
Exactly 16 days ago, I received a letter firing me from government of the Republic of Zimbabwe as Vice President. Within two hours, I was informed about plans to eliminate me. Realizing that on the 12th of August this year, I was subjected to poisoning, which resulted in my being airlifted to South Africa. And again, I thank you, the people of Zimbabwe, for your prayers. I survived that poison. This time around, I say to myself, I should not wait for them to eliminate me, but let me go out and with you, the people of Zimbabwe, the people of ZANU-PF, make your voice be heard. Today, this evening, I feel so humbled that we have remained here until this hour,
yes,
at our headquarters,
yes,
waiting for me,
yes,
that you see me and I see you. The G40 cabal had captured the executive in the person of our president. Orders were now coming not from the executive, from people outside the executive to implement in government and to run government. But the people of Zimbabwe yourselves have refused. I think
you have heard or read my letter. I sent
to His Excellency asking the President Mugabe and say, Mr. President, the people have spoken. You yourself said, if the people say I must step down, you shall comply. This is time to comply. Because the voice of the people is the voice of God. Today, we are witnessing the beginning of a new and unfolding democracy in our country. I wish also to thank the manner in which our defense forces and the leadership of General Chiwenga have been able to manage this process very peacefully. I was in constant contact with the service chiefs throughout. And may I also inform you that in my discussions with some heads of state, including spending today about 1.5 hours with President Zuma, also the President of Namibia, the former President of Tanzania, Kikwete, and others, they hailed the discipline and the peacefulness of the people of Zimbabwe. They are saying the way we have managed this process makes SADC proud, not only on this continent, but worldwide. May I thank my colleagues, led by Comrade Mpofu in the Politburo, who systematically, constitutionally, processed the process which led to a point where the president, the former president Mugabe, signed to say, I now step down. He is now the former president of the Republic of Zimbabwe. Humility and profound gratitude to my colleagues in the Central Committee and Politburo in the manner in which they constitutionally processed the resolutions which persuaded this moment to come by. Currently, also, before I conclude, because time is gone, I'm going to make my formal speech on Friday, around 10 o'clock. I also wish to mention the manner in which the Speaker of Parliament handled the process. He was under tremendous pressure from the powers that were at the time, but he stood his constitutional rights as a speaker. I applaud him for that. The intention to derail this process, that intention was intense, but as he said, the will of the people will always, always succeed. Vanenge vasingadi vachagara vachingobukura.
Tonga.
Mutimbo Tonga.
Mutimbo Tonga.
Matimbo Lukura. Be your servant. I appeal to all genuine patriotic Zimbabweans to come together. We work together. No one is more important than the other. All Zimbabweans want to grow our economy. We want peace in our country. We want jobs. Jobs. Of our neighbors in SADC, we need the cooperation of the continent of Africa. We need the cooperation of our friends outside the continent. That we shall achieve. I'm already receiving messages of cooperation and support for us to grow our economy. Zakawanda, Topanyam Soros in your Kai, and this you put in Sorapanyam, the one. Mari Alkin Sorrow, he knows Ziva. Nokushinga, nokutsunga kwa maita. Musi wechishanu, vakawanda vavimbisa, vachange vanesu. Amen. 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 Amen.